paper, we investigate the impact of openness to trade and openness to migration on African economies. Donc, we use a data on, we use a word sample and find that one geographic characteristic are used to instrument both trade and migration. There is no significant impact of trade, while there are strong positive effects of migration on income. However, the study of Ortega and Perry doesn't account for heterogeneity of country. Therefore, we focus on the specific case of Africa for the following reason. First, Africa trade is mainly realized with developed countries, and intracontinental trade is very low. At the same time, there is a strong intracontinental migration and emigration to industrial countries. This is confirmed by this following figure. One can see that intracontinental migration represents more than half of the total African migration. At the same time, immigration from Africa to OECD countries represents more than 30% of African immigration. Concerning trade, intracontinental trade are less than 20% of the total Africa trade. At the same time, trade with developing countries represents more than 60% of Africa trade. So one can think that the impact of openness on Africa growth may depend on the type of partner. Particularly concerning the partner varying impact of trade openness, if we rely on new trade theory, a country can obtain advanced technology from its trading partner through trade. In this case, to examine the impact in function of a subset of partner, we conduct the following regression in which we focus on a particular subset of partner. This subset may be the subset of African partners, the subset of partner among developing countries, or the subset of partner among industrial countries. So for trade, we just take trade, a measure of trade openness with the subset of a subset S of partners. For immigration, the definition depends on the subset of partner. For example, in the intra-African case, we measure immigration received by an African country from other African countries. In the case of Africa trade, Africa openness with non-industrial countries, we also use immigration from received by an African country from non-industrial countries, including African countries. In the case of Africa openness with industrial countries, the measure of openness to migration is we use immigration because it's more relevant. We have immigration from Africa to OECD country, while immigration from OECD to Africa is very insignificant. To construct our instrument, we rely on this gravity regression in which we regress the logarithm of bilateral trade or bilateral migration. Bilateral trade is the sum of export and imports between country G and G plus divided by GDP of the origin country I. For bilateral migration, we take the sum of immigrants born in country G and living in country I as share of country I population. We construct bilateral immigration in the same way by replacing I by G. For control depend explanatory variable, we use distance between the two countries. We use population and area. We use a demi-variable for long countries, a demi-variable for boring, for sharing a common border, a demi-variable for colonial relationships, a demi-variable for sharing a common official language, and a demi-variable that account for sharing of a common currency. We finally use a measure for time difference, a measure of time zone difference between the two countries. After estimating this gravity regression, we compute the gravity-based instrument. For example, the gravity-based predictor for total openness is given by summing up over the partner of countries, all the partner of countries. For example, this is the case of trade, in which Z here is a vector of explanatory variable in gravity regression, and gamma is the vector of estimate coefficient in the gravity regression for trade. We do the same thing for migration. For the subset of for a subset of partners, we sum up only on the subset of partners. We make for trade for migration, we do the same thing. We focus only on the subset of partners. Just something about the estimation method of gravity regression. We use two methods. The first is a linear OLS estimator that we call later linear predictive instrument. The second is the non-linear Poisson Pistolet maximum likelihood proposed by Silva and Turvo 2006. This method has two advantages. The first is it allows to deal with oscillation of a dependent variable with zero value. The second advantage is it allows to take account heterocyclicity related issues in the gravity regression. We call it the non-linear predictive instrument. Concerning data, we use data on 200 countries in the world, including 52 African countries for the year 2000. Our bilateral trade are taken from IMF, Direction of Trade Strategy. Data on bilateral migration are taken from Doke and Cortez. We take geographic variables from CFI gravity database. And our dependent variable is the real percent poverty parity adjusted GDP per person taken from Pennywall tables. The population data is taken from World Bank, and our colonial control are taken from Acemoglu and Kikofa. This is the result of the baseline case, that is the impact of total openness with the world. If you look at the first column, that is when we use the linear predicted as instrument, we find that if you consider a narrow set of control, trade has a significant impact on income. While if you control for extensive set of control, trade becomes insignificant, while immigration have a positive significant impact. In the last two columns, we use the non-linear predict instrument. If you use a narrow set of instrument, trade is significant. While if you use the extensive set of control, trade is not significant and migration is not significant. So one can see here, from Africa, we don't have a significant impact of migration on trade, as found by Ortega and Pérez. So now we look at the time, the impact dependent on the subset of partner. In the last, the first four column, we investigate the impact of Africa opening with African countries. If you look at in trade is not significant and immigration is not significant. In any case, we have a significant impact of trade and immigration. We do the same thing with Africa openness with non-industrial countries. Only if you use a extensive set of control, migration is positive when we use the linear predict instrument, while trade is significant if you use the non-linear case. Now we focus now on the case of Africa openness with industrial countries. In this case, the openness to migration is measured by immigration. Okay. So if you look at the first column with the narrow set of instruments, trade and immigration have a positive impact. That are significant. However, if you use the extensive set of control, only trade remains significant. In the non-linear case, trade is significant, while immigration has not a significant impact. Here we found a strong evidence of a positive impact of trade with developed countries on African economies. So in the last step, we asked whether how trade with industrial countries promote growth in Africa. We think that if you rely on new trade theory, this may be due to the transfer of technologies. Now we will check for this based on the output decomposition of Al and Jones. In this decomposition, the output is a Cobb-like function of physical capital and human capital. So we can rewrite this expression in per workers, and we show that income per capita is the sum of, in logarithm, is the sum of physical capital, human capital, and technology. In this case, to make the decomposition, human capital is assumed to be a function of return to school as estimated in Mincerian wage regression. And we set alpha to 1/3 in line with standard neoclassical approach. This is the result of the decomposition. In the first column, we just report the significant impact of trade on income per capita. In the last column, we report the impact on physical capital. We think that the impact is not significant. In the third column, we report for the impact for human capital is not significant. In the last column, we report for productivity. It is highly significant. So we see here that trade with developing countries promote growth in Africa, particularly through the transfer of technology. To conclude, in the paper, we show that the impact of trade of openness on African economies depend on the type of openness. For example, trade and migration, and it depend also on partner. It depend on type of openness, trade or migration, it depend on the partner. We find that if no impact of immigration, whatever the partner. While we found that trading more with developing countries helps to promote growth in Africa, particularly through the transfer of technologies. Okay, thank you.